Hello students, GateSPC Online Person welcomes you, and today in this video we are going to discuss about November 2019 current affair and also yearly Hyperloop. Before I just provided one poll on our YouTube channel, so some students just provided said also provide this November 2019 current affair. For those students, just I am providing November 2019 current affair also. In November 2019 current affair, no important topics are there. Basically 10 points are there, like 10-12 points, very important points are there. For exam you can just also read. So for because student have some problem, sir, if we not go for this November current affair, there may be chances of questions. So for those student, like if you in doubt, your preparation is a problem. That's why for those student, I am just providing November 2019 current affair. From November, no important topics, only 5-10 points, just read. For all students, just I need suggest go for this 10 points. And very important in this video, I will also provide yearly Hyperloop. Before I was thinking like I provide only the article for like PSU disinvestment in last this year. Very important news, PSU disinvestment, also NRC list, also one important topic, past tag. For past tag already just I provided one article. So some important topics and year in 2019, number of bills passed, your this EWS will, NIA will 2019. So some important bills from 2019 also in this video, we are going to cover everything. So this is going to be like maximum to maximum, you can just read from current affair part. No need to just waste your time for current affair part. Students always thinking. That's why just I am providing November also, because the student have doubt in your mind. If you just going for exam with doubt, definitely you will losing your marks. For those student or for every student, just I am providing November 2019 current affair also. So from November, nothing is important, only 2-3 topics. Like one is just like some students also asking, sir, Ram Mandir conclusion. So everything just we are going to discuss in this video. And before starting of this video, I need to suggest guys, now less than 30 days of time just remaining. Now what you need to do? Basically some students, they just leaving their preparation and just thinking about IES 2021. For those students, I need to suggest only you have two options. Don't go for this option. Go for this exam properly, guys. Because if you are preparing for IES 2021 also, this is like a first step for your success. If you are going this year properly, definitely next year you will get very good confidence and then you will get very good marks in your this exam. For those students, you have single option. Because time is just less than 30 days, what you can do? You can just for sir GS part, just only go through our videos and basic notes. Because in 30 days, you cannot read everything. But if you go through our videos and notes, that will great help in your exam. And for technical part, only solve last year papers. This is like for those students who don't want to go for this IES 2020 and just they are quitting at the last moment and thinking about next year. For those students also, I need to suggest go through our videos and technical part last year papers. This is like if you done properly, definitely guys, you will just attempt that paper and you will get confidence. And for those students, if you are preparing properly for this exam, I need to suggest for GS, just go through videos plus theory reading of books. Definitely it will sufficient for your exam. And for technical part, some students just thinking, sir, I have completed my 9 subject technical completely. Remaining 3 subjects are there. Guys, don't waste your time because time is just less than 30 days. So just left this subject, 9 prepare properly. I need to suggest for 9 subjects, give your old last year papers one time, two time. Revision is a very important because this is like an exam where revision is a very important. So just go for revision for your technical and GS part properly. And if you just left your 3 subject or 4 subject, for those subjects also solve last year papers. Don't completely or blankly go for this subject. Solve last year papers. You, if you know, then okay. If you don't know, then also okay. Because sometimes what happen from these subjects, basic questions may ask, theoretical question, basic formula based question just they can ask. Don't go completely left of any subject. Just revise like basic formula and last year papers. This is like a completely you can just do in last 30 days. So this is like a very important strategy. Don't waste your time. Just prepare continuously and don't think about next year or whatever just going to be happen after exam. Don't worry about that. Thing is that 5 January 2020 is going to be very important for you. Just go for your exam. Just think about this exam. And only thing is that in next 2-3 days, definitely your IES 2020 exam admit cards also going to be there. So I will just update on our website. So don't worry about that, everything just I will provide. So your work, just read and just be confident, be positive. Definitely you will do, guys. Every student, toppers also doing same thing. So don't think like you are just not attempting test series or thinking about useless things. Just think is that you just prepare, definitely you will get very good score in this exam. So this is like a maximum to maximum you can just do in last 30 days, and this is not time to thinking, guys. This is time to take action. If you do action, then only possibly you will get good marks. For example, this is also like for those students, like they don't know, like, sir, I don't want to just go for this exam. I just totally demotivated. I need to suggest go for GS and technical properly last year papers. That is going to be sufficient. If you can able to solve two times, three times these things, it is going to be very, very good. For those students, already you prepared properly, guys, make revision one time, two time, three time. How many times you can just do, because your time is going to be very less at the time in last, you forget everything. So this is like a very important time and crucial time for revision. Just go for revision properly. So now we are going to discuss our November 2019 current affair, as well as some yearly hyperloop topics like PSU disinvestment, because of this is like an economic topic, and in IES current affair part, these economic topics are going to be very, very important. That's why everything just we are going to discuss. So before we are going to discuss like some important 10-12 points from November 2019 current affair, after that in last of this video we are going to discuss some very, very important current affair for this IES 2020 pre. Now, first current affair, Vega second NASA solar system explorer reaches interstellar space. So, sir, sometimes in UPSC, they can just ask this Voyager mission from NASA is just related to what? Sir, this is related to study of our solar system. For example, sir, in our solar system, we have Sun, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. Okay, so these are like our planets, and this Voyager second is just for what? This is going to be a study of our outer past of our satellites like Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. So this second mission for these four planets, Saturn, Jupiter, Neptune and Uranus, because of from Earth, like for Mars or from our moons, we have different mission. But this is like a USA, a very good mission. It is going to be a study of Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. So this is like, so this is for outer planets from our solar system. Now, second topic, Ayodhya verdict 2019, and in this topic, like some students just asking repeatedly, sir, this is going to be very important. I need to suggest, guys, this is only political matter. That's why that is important. There is nothing important from this Ayodhya verdict. Only thing is that some important topics they can just ask. One is just, sir, basically, sir, this verdict is related to like 5 acre just they given for Ram Mandir, and 5 acre also they provided Sunni board for this mosque. So this is like a maximum to maximum they can just ask, and also very important. 5-judge bench. This is like 5-judge bench given this decision and headed by CJI Ranjan Gogoi. This is like an important point. CJI Gogoi just retired and now 47th our new CJI S.A. Bobde. And sir, what is the history of this Ram Mandir? Sir, in 1992, this Babri Masjid totally demolished, and after that, this case is just gone through this all courts and high courts. So in 2010, Allahabad High Court also provided some judgment related to this issue. So what happened? They provided just divided every this land to all three, Nirmohi Akhada, Sunivab Board and Ramlalla. So all three just divided properly and just take this 5 acre properly. Like for example, this is for like Ramlalla, for this like Nirmohi Akhada, this is for Sunni Board. But sir, they again just go to this Supreme Court. Now Supreme Court just given this land 5 acre for Ram Mandir and 5 acre for Sunivab Board for mosque. So this is like a maximum to maximum you can just learn from this Ayodhya verdict 2019. Now sir, next current affair, SC verdict. CJI office under RTI now. What happened, guys? We have right to information. So far, only right to information for Supreme Court, like CJI, Chief Justice of India, cannot like go for this RTI information. But now, just Supreme Court just verdicted, like CJI office also under RTI. So if any decision is there, you can just ask RTI like on what basis you just given this decision. So this office is also come under your this RTI information. Now fourth current affair, United Nations Development Program provided green climate fund for India. Nearly $43 million. they just provided for climate in three coastal states. So India got this fund to just development of our coastal lands properly. There is a, like lots of climate change are there. So for that, just for development, they just provided this green climate fund. Sometimes they, in UPSC, they can just ask this green climate fund just related to what and who provide. So this is like provided by United Nations Development Program. Now, sir, fifth, Health Ministry launched SAS campaign, and this SAS is nothing, sir, social awareness and action to neutralize our pneumonia successfully. So guys, what happened recently, this is why this government just launched this scheme, because of recently our UNICEF, United Nations, like international organization, just provided one report where just they given largest pneumonia deaths or mortality rate in childs just by our this India. India is just second largest. That's why India government is also like thinking our this mortality rate is going to increasing every year, and this is like also due to in world our second position due to our pneumonia disease only. That's why government just working this special scheme and campaign is there, that is known as SAS campaign. So in the exam they can just ask this SAS campaign is just related to what, to eradicate our this pneumonia disease, and there may be chances of vaccines or something is there. Now sixth current affair, Cartosat 3, and ISRO launched this Cartosat 3 plus 13 nano satellite for USA. So this is like with our PSLV C-47. So nano satellite is like basically it is like going to from USA, and our Cartosat 3 version is going to be advanced version of our imaging and mapping satellite. So this Cartosat for what just India launch for our imaging and mapping, and this will provide high resolution images for government of India, and this will provide a very good information. Now seventh important point, emission gap report 2019, and very important question for UPSC. They can just ask emission gap report just published by which department? UNEP, United Nations Environmental. Okay, so what happened, this report suggested, this report warns that earth temperature may rise by 3.2 degree by 2100. So what happened guys, there is a temperature increasing due to what, our greenhouse gases. So they just want like just reduce our this emission of greenhouse gases, because of India is also in top four countries providing this greenhouse emission for this CO2 or pollution. So from this only thing is that like emission gap just reported provided by this UNEP, and they just suggested this by 2100 we are going to increase earth temperature may going to increase 3.2 degree centigrade. Now 8th current affair, 55th Jennifer Award, this is given to Ekitam Achutam Nambudri, and this is Malayalam writer. 9th current affair, the year in which the main Soccer World Cup in 2023 is going to be held in India, and it is going to be held in Bhuneswar and Rukela. Now sir, 10th, motto of Lokpal, already just this year in monthly current affair we have discussed sir, we just launched a special department Lokpal now, and for this year our chairman for this Lokpal is going to be Pinaki Chandra Ghosh, and they just launched this motto for Lokpal, Ma Gridhe Kasyas Vidhanam, means sir this is like a Sanskrit word, and this means do not be greedy for anyone's wealth. Okay, so this is like a motto for Lokpal. Now sir, 11th, Oxford Word of the Year 2019, means sir every year Oxford publishes one word for the year. So 2019 this word is important, climate emergency, so this is going to be word of the year. Now 12th current affair, BRICS summit 2019, and this is going to be 11th summit held at Brazil, and theme for this summit, economic growth for innovative future. 13th sir, Asian summit in 2019, this was 35th summit at Bangkok. So these are like some important current affair from November 2019, and this is like a basic 13 point, especially here some important topics like your Vayogar second, as well as like UNDP green climate fund, also sir SAS scheme, and sir Cartosat 3, UNEP emission gap report. These are like sir, only some important topics from this November 2019 month. So these 13 points just I provided, just go through the basic reading, that is going to be sufficient for your exam. Now sir, this year very important topic, that is known as PSU disinvestment. Every time, every month, we are thinking about or we are talking, sir, BSNL privatization, Bharat Petroleum privatization. Every time in economic perspective, this current affair is going to be very, very important. They can just ask any type of question. That's why especially one small article just I'm providing here. Just listen very carefully for next 5-10 minutes. It is going to be very, very important for your exam. And from these topics, not only single topic for economic, lots of topics are going to be clear from this topic only. Now, sir, what do you mean by PSU disinvestment? PSU one is, sir, known as investment. So investment is there. For example, our government is there and they are spending some money. For example, 51% money by government, that is known as investment. Disinvestment means, sir, we are taking our partnership. For example, now, sir, we are taking our total money or also, sir, we are reducing our shares. So that is known as PSU disinvestment. And recently, why, sir, government is going for this PSU disinvestment? Because, sir, our GDP is going to decrease. And also, sir, in India, we have consumer GDP. Means, sir, we are consuming more. But that's why our this domestic capital is going to be very important. That is known as domestic money. For government, already this fiscal deficit and current deficit problem. That's why from where we will get money? Because government running lots of scheme, but we have not proper money. So what happened? Government going for this disinvestment. They're taking money. For example, sir, recently they have taken 5 PSUs. First, Bharat Petroleum. Second, sir, SCI Shipping Corporation of India. This Container Corporation, Thierry Hydro Development, and this Northeast Electrical Power Corporation. So they are selling these all 5 PSUs to someone. It may be private company, it may be like some PSU. So that is going to be like different way, but they are selling. But sir, this Bharat Petroleum, even profit making, this is like making lots of profit, Bharat Petroleum. But why, sir, government selling? Because of, by this selling of this Bharat Petroleum, our government can take 63,000 crore rupees only from this only. So this is like initial, it may can earn 80,000 crore rupees from only selling Bharat Petroleum. That's why our capital or domestic money is going to be increased. Now government is spend more on our this our different projects of government. So that's why they are selling this Bharat Petroleum also. So this is known as PSU disinvestment. Now sir, government have target. They want 1 lakh crore rupees domestic money. In future, they can just increase to 1,50,000 crore rupees. They want domestic money, PSU disinvestment. So these are like the thing is that to increase our domestic money, we are going for PSU disinvestment. So basically, sir, three types of PSU disinvestment. First is, sir, minority. Minority means, sir, we are, for example, sir, government is there and we have spent our 51% shares in some PSU. So only thing is that minority disinvestment means, sir, only we are reducing our shares, but still more than 51% shares in any company. That is known as minority. Majority means, sir, for example, sir, in government only have 25% share plus 75% from public or private. So that is known as majority. Now, sir, third is very, very important. That is known as total disinvestment. Means, sir, 100% disinvestment. And this is also known as strategic disinvestment. Last year, this year, total time you just read the newspaper, every time you just listening this word, strategic disinvestment. In UPSC, these types of questions are going to be favorite. That's why they can just ask, strategic disinvestment means, sir, this means your 100% of your this partnership is going to be closed. Means, sir, government making 100% privatization, no control. Even, for example, sir, in these things, government have like interfere, but in total disinvestment, 100% control to buyer. For example, for BPCL, like some another company from like Saudi Arabia, just take, they will provide 100% control. Government, after selling, they will not interfere. So this is known as total disinvestment. Now, sir, main motto to increase cash and money and reduce financial burden to government. Because of government have other projects, that's why we are going for PSU disinvestments. Also guys, for this, I just provided notes in our PDF form. You can just check the description. So guys, what happened? This is not only today. I will provide this total information of PSU disinvestment. So PSU disinvestment means, sir, basically government just taking their share back. That is known as disinvestment. Basically three types: minority, majority, and total. Total is also known as strategic disinvestment. So this is also known as your basically privatization of your PSUs. Now, sir, what happened? This is not only this year. Many times in past time, 1991-1992, at that time our finance minister Manmohan Singh, because of at that time also like our GDP problem, lots of problems, our economy is like stuck up. At that time government is also started this PSU disinvestment. And from this one important question UPSC may ask, that is, in 1993 who suggested, one committee is there for this PSU disinvestment? This is known as the Rangaranjan Committee of Disinvestment. So in UPSC they can just ask, Rangaranjan Committee is just related to what? PSU disinvestment. Because UPSC may ask this question, or also they can just ask this committee related question. That's why just a special article. If I provide only written form, you cannot understand. So in video I just providing a basic idea of PSU disinvestment. Now sir, before what happened, this one department is there, Niti Aayog, only control this PSU disinvestment problems. But now one special department government just constructed, that is known as this DIPAM, Department of Investment and Public Asset Management. Now what happens, sir, our Niti Aayog plus your this DIPAM both just going to cover this PSU disinvestment. Everything just done by this Niti Aayog and DIPAM. Very important. They can just ask this PSU disinvestment. Now recently government just created one department, Department of Investment and Public Asset Management. So this is going to be, guys, maximum to maximum you can just learn from this PSU disinvestment. Only basic idea, sir, government reducing their shares. This is like opposite to investment. And thing is that, sir, this year government is going for this total disinvestment of BPCL or like BSNL or some different companies are there. So that is known as this strategic disinvestment. Also, sir, for example, sir, this TSD or this Northeast Electrical Power Corporation Limited, these are going to be sold to our NTPC. So in this like minority disinvestments or like majority disinvestments only there, they are not selling their total shares like for this THD or this NIPCO. But sir, for Bharat Petroleum, they are going for this 100% selling. This is known as strategic. So you should have a proper idea. What do you mean by minority disinvestment? What do you mean by majority disinvestment? What do you mean by total disinvestment? One is, sir, in 1993, one committee is the Rangaranjan Committee. This is related to what? And now, sir, one department, DIPAM, Department of Investment and Public Assessment. So that is going to be sufficient maximum to maximum. They can just ask any question. You can just able to. So this is like a very, very important topic for IES Pre-2020. Now, sir, second important topic of this year, NRC. NRC is nothing, sir, National Register of Citizen. Very important. UPSC can just they ask, what do you mean by this NRC, or NRC in news, what do you mean by that? So this is nothing, sir, to separate illegal immigrants from legitimate residents of Assam. So recently our Assam government just provided one list, NRC list, where nearly our 90 lakh persons out of this list means that they are from Bangladesh or they are from other country. So this is known as NRC list. So this list first published in 1951, in the after census of 1951. So this is known as basically NRC. So you should have idea of NRC also. Now final important topics from this important current affair of 2019. First is, sir, this important bills. This year some important bills just passed in our Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, and after signing of this bills, they just converted into act. So best of all, basic idea you should have, sir, bills are there. So bills just published in Lok Sabha, then just or maybe Rajya Sabha. So they just pass with majority, then just they pass in different house with majority. After passing in both house, they just converted into act after sign of president. So you should understand. So these are like some past bills. All bills are going to be very important for your exam. So first important bill, the Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu. Just merger of unity means, sir, both with the name of this bill, you can just, sir, this both UTs are going to be merged now. Now, sir, second, the Special Protection Group SPG Amendment Bill 2019. So it will provide what happens, sir, this bill for SPG will provide security to the Prime Minister, former Prime Minister and their immediate family members. So this is like a specially amendment bill. Now, sir, third, the Supreme Court number of judge amendment bill. So what happened, sir, before only 30 judges for Supreme Court, but now, sir, 33 judge plus one CJI. चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ इंडिया. नाउ सर दिस नंबर ऑफ जज जस्ट इंक्रीज 32 to 33. सो दिस इज लाइक अमेंडमेंट बिल फॉर सुप्रीम कोर्ट. नाउ फोर्थ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दिस ईयर वी जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड लाइक इन अवर मंथली करंट अफेयर ऑल्सो लाइक बेड लोन्स. बेड लोन्स इज नथिंग सर लाइक जस्ट समवन टेकिंग लोन एंड दे नॉट प्रोवाइडिंग आउट स्टैंडिंग, दैट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज वन केस ऑफ इनसॉल्वेंसी. सो वॉट हैपन अवर विजय माल्या, नीरव मोदी, जस्ट दे टेकन लोन एंड जस्ट गो आउटसाइड ऑफ दिस कंट्री. सो जस्ट दे प्रोवाइडेड वन बिल जस्ट टू अमेंड दिस बिल ऑफ दिस इनसॉल्वेंसी एंड बैंक्रप्सी. So what they will provide, this provide time-bounded process for resolving insolvency and companies or among individuals. So before what happened like 1 year, 2 year for this bill, but now they provided proper special time. You should take action for this bad loans or this bad asset. So insolvency is the situation where individual or company are unable to pay their outstanding or debt. Now sir, next, this year like highlight topic, the Motor Vehicle Act, and they just increase this rate of this fine rates. So that's why it will amend the Motor Vehicle Act of 1988, and this act will provide for road safety, grant of license, and also like penalties for violation of these provisions. Now sir, 6, Muslim women's protection of rights of marriage. Basically this is known as Teen Talaq. So already this bills we just discussed in our monthly current affair. Also sir, 7th, 24th Amendment Bill 2019. This is for what? Like economic or weaker section, and this will change your Article 15. So already in our January 2019 current affair, we have just discussed everything in proper manner. And also sir, our 8 important bill like NIA, National Investigation Agency, one bill is there. I think just we have read this in September or July current affair. Okay, so you can just read from there. So this is like also for this case, like Nirav Modi and our this Vijay Mallya just gone outside of this country. So we should take action outside of that country. So for some amendments are there. So that will just we have covered there. So these are like some important topics from this IAS current affair. I just given here already guys, all videos just I provided on our YouTube videos, basic 5 videos plus sir, up to November now sir, up to November you can just read, and that is going to maximum read from this current affair part. Okay, so guys, thing is that now sir, less than 30 days time, you just only follow your strategy, it is time for action. So now guys, this video is just over. Go with full confidence. I just wish my every student, do your best of best. I'm not talking about results only. Just do your best of best. Give your best of best. So thank you guys for watching this video. Thank you.